What can be done about twitching?
This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description.
Rob Anderson says, what is your algorithm for determining and fixing the cause of eye twitching? I'm going to go through it in a kind of rapid bullet point format now, but basically any twitching is going to be due to either excess of glutamate over GABA in the, so we're like kind of tracing down from the neurological control of in the central nervous system to the peripheral nervous system to the muscle. We're first thinking about GABA balance in the synapse. Then we're thinking about acetylcholine balance in the synapse. And when we're thinking about GABA balance, we are thinking about the things that impact the glutamate and GABA levels. So that can be, for example, vitamin B6 is involved in the interchange. Plasma glucose is a key driver of central glutamate. There are, like I was saying, numerous other things you would think about glutamate GABA balance. But the chief things are the B6 and the balance between the two. And then the sodium, potassium, and chloride in terms of controlling the synaptic clearance of glutamate. Then calcium in terms of controlling synaptic vesicle release. And generally those, I doubt acetylcholine is going to typically be a cause of twitching, but if someone's supplementing alpha-GPC or they have organophosphate pesticide poisoning or something like that, then, acetylcholine can become much more relevant. Or if they're taking an acetylcholinesterase inhibitor, or they're taking ginkgo biloba, which has natural acetylcholinesterase inhibitors, those types of things are where you might see acetylcholine come into play. Whereas if someone's not, doesn't have pesticide exposure and doesn't have, they're not taking ginkgo, they're not taking alpha GPC, they're not taking acetylcholinesterase inhibitors, they're not taking huperzine A, I'm going to be much more focused on the glutamate GABA balance in those people. And then calcium comes into play again as the preeminent determinant of muscular contraction. And then magnesium and ATP come in as the controller of the clearance of calcium in the muscle cell, as well as the clearance of calcium where it controls vesicle release. And magnesium also comes into play in the as the off switch for NMDA receptors, which are a subset for glutamate receptors. And then ATP opens up the whole giant basket of every single one of the B vitamins, potassium, iron, copper, sulfur, and to repeat again, magnesium. So I would say that, and then of course, acid-base balance is going to determine electrolyte handling and is also going to determine glutamate levels, because it's the key regulator of glutaminase, which hydrolyzes glutamine to form glutamate in order to form ammonia to mop up the acidity. So if I'm going to consider those and what is most actionable about those, the most actionable steps are supplementation with electrolytes, which are going to be generally quick acting, supplementation with B vitamins, which if they're playing a nutritional role rather than like mopping up sulfite, I forgot to mention sulfite. So sulfite enhances glutamate toxicity and is generally going to rise with a high load of animal protein and a low molybdenum intake. I think that the things you can most acutely control are usually electrolytes and acid-base balance. And I think supplementing with molybdenum to control sulfite, or supplementing with B vitamins or any of the other nutritional factors in energy metabolism, I think is generally going to take longer to heal the process. So the first thing you want to do is look at whether your urine pH is off. If it's postprandial, it should be in the 6.4 to 6.8 range. If it's a lot more acidic than that, like in the fives, acidity could be a factor. And if it's above 7, alkalinity could be a factor. And you can modulate that directly with bicarbonate or with acidic foods and beverages. Then if it's responsible to any of the electrolytes, sodium, potassium, chloride, magnesium, calcium, probably not phosphate, but it could be in there. bicarbonate. Those are the major electrolytes, probably sodium and potassium and magnesium and calcium are, well, I mean, really, you got to go through the whole list. So you might get more bang for the buck with one versus another. And so you want to run through the list and see what supplementation helps. I mean, generally, you could start with a dose of around 400 milligrams of any of those and just test their effect, but you might have to titrate up or down to see what they're doing. And then you want to look at things like, you know, does it increase? I should mention that thyroid function can play a big role because it's controlling the rate of energy metabolism, therefore the amount of ATP. So you want to look at things like, do things that increase my metabolism increase the twitching? If so, then it's probably something like a hypermetabolic state that is increasing metabolism and therefore acidity and somehow messing up electrolyte handling, or is generating greater demand for B vitamins and thus a deficiency and thus a misregulation of energy metabolism. And you know, if none of these acute factors are impacting it, then you probably want to measure blood levels of B vitamins or just take a B complex and see if that helps. That would cover most of the bases. So I'd have to write it out to be completely thorough, but that's most of it. Thank you, Rob, for your question.
This is a clip from a live Q&A session open to CMJ Masterpass members. In addition to this episode, you can access lots of other free samples from these sessions at the first link in the description. If you want to become a Masterpass member so that you can participate in the next live Q&A, or so that you can have access to the complete recording and transcript of each Q&A session, you can join at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass. You can save 10% off the subscription price for as long as you remain a member by signing up at chrismasterjohnphd.substack.com/Q&A. That's Q&A spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A. These links are in the description.